heavyweight title eliminator match with Jumpin' Joe Savoldi against Fabulous Phil Apollo. How long have we waited to see this one? And a title tag team match with champions Prince Mike Kahlua and Tom Mr. Chippendale Brandi, risking their belts against the Boston Bad Boy and the Mad Russian. And we'll see the French sensation Richard Charlin and the sensuous Englishman Exotic Adrian Street. And here's one we always hoped to see but never thought could happen, a mixed tag team with Hillbilly Mike and Little Martinez facing the only undefeated giant Gustav and Sky Lolo. And for a main event, the Black Superman Tony Atlas, who's going head to head with the man who knocked out the news, Dr. D. David Schultz. All of these matches and some prizes will be at the Bangor Auditorium October 9th. Remember, we'll be taping for TV coverage, so here's a great chance for you to go out and support your favorite wrestler. Get your tickets at the auditorium or Sandy's downtown.
Bob, you'll be guy.
We were at...
Irish Pat Sullivan.
Time right now.
No, your pleasure. It's your pleasure.
All right, here we go.
The Exotic going dancing around the ring, and Pat Sullivan not quite sure, I guess, what to make out of it. It could be that Pat maybe is just afraid to lock up on that collar elbow hookup and get too close, you know, chin to chin.
Boy, that's true. I don't know whether I'd like to, Oh, look at this. He has no choice.
Well, what do you call that? A flying sit? Whatever it was effective putting him to the canvas. And I told you about this guy, Steve. That good forearm smash. It's stopping now. The inside of the thighs. Oh,
boom!
Look at that move. That has to be awfully painful to Pat Sullivan.
Close to a submission hole there.
I thought he was going to go for the figure four or Indian Deathlock.
Going right to work now. Look at this.
Step over toe hold and he rolled.
Adrian straight.
Well, it's an interesting phenomenon. It is, catapulting Pat Sullivan between the second and top rope as Miss Linda claps approval the other side of the ring and off the ring apron.
Now on the hardwood floor. Oh, a hard elbow smash.
Just goes once again to prove, Steve, that appearances can in fact be deceiving, does it not?
No doubt about that. Irish Pat Sullivan, dazed. Look at this.
Well, he missed. He went. That was an attempt, an interesting move. He went to, flying leg scissors on the arm, stomping the chin of Irish Pat Sullivan. This man, I'll tell you, they talk about asking no quarter, giving none, hooking the leg again, the mark of a top professional wrestler, and in very short order, the exotic Adrian Street. And he continues to dish out the punishment. Steve, good luck.
Oh, thanks.
Wrestling fans, they don't go anywhere. It's Steve's pleasure, and certainly my pleasure, that it's him going into the ring right now to interview the exotic Adrian Street. First, we're going to get the official result.
Sundance. He's from Limbrook, New York. 222 pounds.
A very ample midsection, one might say.
Going up against Mike Sundance here on International Championship Wrestling. Steve Butt at ringside along with Milt Avruskin.
I'll tell you something. This is one of the largest men I've ever seen in professional wrestling. And you know, the first big country boy, you might say, was Haystack Calhoun, who, by the way, for those of you who weren't aware, has since passed away. But this man is bigger. I was fortunate enough to know Haystacks. This man's bigger.
Well, I'll tell you, Haystack came in, they said, maybe around 500 or 600 pounds, but maybe not.
I think it was exaggerated a touch.
I would say so.
But this is one large man, this Hillbilly Mike, and I understand that there's another big dude around International Championship Wrestling, the giant Gustav, and I'm not sure whether it's Hillbilly Mike, I'm told, is aiming for Gustav, or whether it's the other way around. Steve, you can inform me.
Well, I've seen many an occasion where Hillbilly Mike and Gustav have been inside the ring with each other, and the gentleman right here has backed off on every occasion.
The Hillbilly has.
He sure has. He's not at all excited about facing Gustav. At least he doesn't show it. And it looks like he's not too happy with what's going on right here with Mike Sundance.
Well, Sundance being very aggressive, but really, the blow's not having any telling effect whatsoever to the big Hillbilly, who lays Sundance down to the canvas with one shot of those great big arms.
Well, there's no question that in order to maybe get even a chance or a shot at Hillbilly Mike or anyone his size, it would seem you have to go at the legs and try to get him off his feet.
Well, yeah, because, I mean, let's face it, a man that size, he's 469 pounds, and what does he stand? He's got to be 6'6", 6'7" in height.
No question, and you wonder why a fellow like Sundance even signs for a match like this.
It would
more or less maybe be a handicap match if he had somebody else in there equal his size.
Put to the canvas with a, I mean, it would have been a clothesline except to cut him across the midsection. The Hillbilly whipping him through the second and top rope and then inviting him to come back up into the ring. Yeah, you've got to take a man this size if you How many men can combat size for size with a man who weighs 460-odd pounds and stands the height that the big hillbilly does? But, you know, everybody's the same size when you're lying flat in your back, Steve.
No question. Which is why, as I say, if you can't get the man off his feet, you see a lot of wrestlers, unfortunately, going for the eyes or a very vulnerable area. Look at this, Sundance trying to lift him off. You gotta be kidding.
Well, he may be able to lift that kind of weight, but it's different when it's live beef on the hoof, so to speak. Being stopped is Sundance by this gigantic hillbilly from Arkansas. He takes the handkerchief out and uses that. And, you know, this is the thing that really gets to me. Well, what is a guy this size?
Yeah.
I mean, it's an obvious overmatch. Sundance is out of his league from a size perspective. And he doesn't have, let's say, an inordinate amount of skill. The amount required to combat the excessive size that the hillbilly possesses. So why does the hillbilly have to go to what he's doing?
Look at this. Oh,
big splash.
No way. He can stay down for 10.
Mike Sundance almost became a pancake. And maybe it's fortunate for him that the match ended when it did. The count of three going in after that big splash. What can we say except that hillbilly Mike is victorious here in International Championship Wrestling, and we'll hear it now officially.
Here's Mac.
And your winner, the big man, Hillbilly Mike.
Hillbilly Mike, 469 pounds right here on International Championship Wrestling. Look at this, and he's going to finish him off. Wow.
Some people have little to no class.
All right, stay tuned for wrestling action right after this.
Yeah, baby, Rockland, Maine, we're coming. A lot of people are coming. Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, Dr. D. David Schultz, Adrian Street, Joe Savoli, Phil Apollo, everyone's going to be there. And, of course, your tag team champions, the people's champions, we're going to be there to take care of business. We don't care who we got to take because we are number one.
I'll tell you one thing, national television coverage, that's what it's all about. So the people at home can watch tag team champions of the ICW. Bring it to you. The belts are on the line. Anybody that wants them, got to take them from us first because we are number one, the ICW.
Right here. October 10th at Rockland High School. Don't miss this one. Come and see Dr. D.
Underway this match, the man Russia Nikita Malkovich invading the ring. Steve jumping his smaller opponent, Nicky Gilligan. I mean, from behind. I don't know. You fill me in on this guy Malkovich.
Well, I'll tell you something. Just like his native country does to lesser countries, he has done it here to Mickey Gilligan. He just charges in, and Malkovich following in the footsteps of all the other famous Russian wrestlers. Right down the line. They seem to come in to make a statement.
Nice move by Mickey Gilligan. And he got a two count and almost stole a quick pinfall from the mad Russian Malkovich, who tosses Gilligan out of the ring between the second and top rope for his troubles. I'll tell you something. Malkovich had to have his heart skip a beat because it was an eyelash away from a very impressive upset victory being scored by Mickey Gilligan over the Mad Russian.
And as we see again and again, even though it hasn't been highlighted, Gilligan from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania must feel, look at this. Oh!
Well, you know something, Malkovich didn't hold him up long enough, and Gilligan was lucky. He got his feet down, really that suplex did not have nearly the force that Malkovich intended it to have. And that, Steve, in case you weren't aware, is how a wrestler acquires cauliflower ears.
From that little maneuver
that'll do it.
That and hard headlocks, I guess.
Yep. But, you know, you talk about hard headlocks. Ask one Angelo Savoldi what it was like to put in the headlock of Ed Strangler Lewis, whose most famous protege was the great Lou Dess.
Very true. And as I was saying, Gilligan from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, even though he may not feel it, he does represent the United States in this particular match. Oh, wow.
Well, that's true. It's the free world and all that. time, but you know something? He's a professional singles competitor, and it was Mickey Gilligan in there against Nikita Malkovich, the Mad Russian, who, and I guess it's become a very habitual thing in international championship wrestling, was again Nikita Malkovich victorious.
And your winner from the depths of the Ukraine, the Mad Russian.
The Mad Russian, once again victorious here on International Championship Wrestling, not a crowd favorite. We'll be back right after this.
Our ref, Little Martinez.
A smile on your face, Steve Areno.
Wow.
I think you just fell in love. Or at least heavily in lust.
I'm moving west.
Go west, young man.
Yes.
Isn't that what they say? And how do you think Little Martinez is going to enjoy refereeing this match?
I think very well.
Jamie, take your hat off.
Yeah. Going up against Betty Blackfeather. And Jamie turning around to disrobe and get some of her garb off. Finds herself now at the hands of Betty Blackfeather, who comes down hard. One, two.
Armbar taken by Betty Blackfeather. Jamie West has absorbed a lot of punishment so far in this match. Look at that, two twists on the armbar. Hey, nice reversal by Jamie. Who's in now? She's putting pressure on the arm, on the shoulder. Nice flying head scissors by Betty Blackfeather. Over and down. Hey, these girls have athletic ability.
Yeah, no question. You gotta love it. Right here on International Championship Wrestling, Steve Butter ringside, along with Milt Avruskin. And hope you're enjoying this action.
There comes Betty. Hey, nice drop kick, but a good monkey flip. You know, catching Jamie West coming off the ropes. So far, Miss Blackfeather has had the better of this match, but hey!
Get this.
Oh, she tried for a roll-up, Jamie West, but...
Drop kicks her now, actually, side kicks her right out of the ring.
Well, I was just saying, you know, that Betty Blackfeather had it all her own way during the course of this match, and she showed some pretty good smarts the way she locked her arms around that top rope when Jamie West tried for that roll-up. And, you know, I guess this is a remake of the old pioneer days, because Betty Blackfeather would seem to be an American Indian name, hailing from Cheektowaga, New York, suburb of Buffalo. Nice reversal by Betty, whipping Jamie West in, and maybe she's trying to write what she figures were some of the wrongs done to the native peoples of North America.
Well, we do have our rivalries here in the ICW. Look at this move!
Over top, but Betty Blackfeather rolled out from underneath. She's the shorter of the two girls. Jamie West whipping her off the ropes, bending over, backdrop. Did you see the look of determination on the face of Jamie?
Oh, and Jamie down hard across the chest of Blackfeather. One. Little Martinez, I'm not sure of his refereeing.
I think he's mesmerized by the two ladies he's in the ring with. Holy cow. You know something? That's cause for sinusitis, tonsillitis, just about every other kind of itis. As well as cauliflower ears, what just happened to Betty Blackfeather. Jamie West, I guess, fed up with the punishment she was taking.
All right. Getting ready here. Suplex maybe.
Yes.
Cover.
And you know, I've got to say, and I'll be fair to everyone, but that wasn't a legal suplex. Every wrestler today uses the tights, and you're not allowed to use the tights for leverage. And we saw that. Jamie West did use them when, you know, and taking Betty Blackfeather over. And this Blackfeather, you've got to give her credit. You know, she just keeps coming back. Leapfrog by Jamie West. Flying tackle, too.
What was that?
I bet you Lila Martinez has a date after the matches tonight. There's Scalalu!
Oh, buddy.
My old buddy Sky 1, 2, 3.
There's your cover.
I think he counted 4. I don't think Skylar Lowe's got a date for after the matches.
Well, how do you do?
One of the greats, you know something? You're looking at one of the fabled greats of all time of professional wrestling when you're looking at Skylar Lowe. Jamie West, a young up-and-coming lady wrestler. Skylar Lowe, one of the all-time greats. Here's the official. What is the official result?
I don't know. Let's go to Mac.
Call it a draw. You tell him, Sky.
Will the real ref please stand up?
Mac McManus looking for the real referee. Well, as far as we're concerned, we'll give it to Jamie. She deserves it. She had it covered twice.
Call it a draw and give it to Sky Lolo.
All right. We'll be back with more right after this.
From the combat zone in Boston, 275-pound Boston Bad Boy.
Popular in B-Town. They attack a Jumpin' Joe from behind is the Bad Boy. Is that why they call him the Bad Boy?
The Boston Bad Boy from the combat zone, no less. And he goes after Joe right away.
Well, I'll tell you, he sure did. And he's a big man, this Boston Bad Boy. First elbow smash right to the jaw as Jumpin' Joe came off those ropes. But Joe coming back with a good left hand to the midsection. Second time. The Bad Boy leaves himself wide open for those midsection shots, you know, Steve.
And if you want excitement, it's spelled Joe Savoldi. Look at this guy go. He's lost some weight. He'll get it back.
Well, Jumpin' Joe Savoldi, and I guess he's a descendant of the original Jumpin' Joe Savoldi, one of the all-time greats, mentioned in the same kind of breath as people like Ed Strangler, Lewis, the great Greek Jim Wandos, leg drop. The Bad Boy, I think, right now wishes he was back in the combat zone.
Joe Savoldi going to work on a man who's got to be, it looks to me, 80 to 90 pounds heavier.
But when you're blessed with talent, youth, speed, finesse, as is Jumpin' Joe Savoldi, you know, 50, 60, 70, 80 pounds can be negated.
Boy, I'm looking at that haircut myself now, and I can't imagine what type of blade or
use. There's arrows at the end at one end of it. The hamstrings are being stretched on the Boston Bad Boy by Jumpin' Joe Savoldi. I wonder if he goes back to the combat zone if he runs into Ferrillo and Belker, and you know, did Belker really bark at him?
Joe Savoldi now with the left leg of the Boston Bad Boy.
Putting a twist on it too, I'll tell you. And if you notice, in standing on the other foot, he was scrunching that down pretty good into the canvas. This is a big man, the Boston Bad Boy. And he is a bad boy in Boston, as you said, wearing that t-shirt.
Boy, I don't know who he's trying to please. He's not going to win any
I don't think
any
he cares.
True.
You know, I think he's in there. What a coup for the Bad Boy if he were to score a fall over the former ICW champ, Jumpin' Joe Savoldi. Who, unless I'm misinformed, is still in the running for that belt that has been held up.
Boy, would he love to have that belt back. That's the only thing that's been on his mind. As he regains his strength.
He's been traveling too, has he not, Jumpin' Joe, wrestling in other parts of the world?
No question about it. He's also a private businessman now.
Being choked by the Boston Bad Boy. I'll tell you, this guy's weird.
Oh.
Look, did you see his eyes? You know, this is the thing you have to fear sometimes in a certain individual, is a little, you know, madness.
Not only that, you wonder sometimes why certain people do get into professional wrestling. And you have to wonder about the Boston Bad Boys.
Well, some of them are just big bullies.
I guess.
But the, you know, he's not going to bully Jumpin' Joe. There's too much talent there. A beautiful reversal on the whip from Jumpin' Joe Savoldi. Slamming the Bad Boy. Climbing the whip. He's on the second turnbuckle. The Bad Boy climbing. He doesn't know Joe's on that turnbuckle. He's looking around for him. Whoa, no! What a phenomenal dropkick from the second turnbuckle. The Bad Boy took it right on that chop. And folks, as you witnessed, that's all she wrote for the Boston Bad Boy. He has to wish right now, Steve, as I said before, that he really was back in the combat mode. Jumpin' Joe Savoldi, victorious.
And your winner, Jumpin' Joe Savoldi.
Wow. Sitting at ringside, I felt that one.
You almost felt sorry for the Boston Bad Boy.
Oh, really?
Not quite.
Okay. Joe Savoldi victorious. We'll be back.
Yeah, Fabulous Phil Apollo coming back to Rockland, Maine. You know, wherever the national TV cameras are, you're going to find Fabulous Phil, because I'm the man that everybody wants to see. I'm the man that all the women salivate and drool over. And, you know, you can talk about Joe Savoldi and that big, goofy, seven-foot giant, but it doesn't make a difference. Everyone comes to see me. They want to see the man of the hour, the man with the power, the man too sweet to be sour, Fabulous Phil, coming to your hometown so you can do what you want and say what you want. I can't think of a better place than to shove it right down their throats than in Rockland, Maine on October 10th.
October 10th at Rockland High School. Don't miss this one. Come and see Dr. D. David Schultz, Jumpin' Joe Savoldi, Exotic Adrian Street, and Mitch.
Don't trust anything less. Be warm and safe.